place currently.
No pressure.
Next is named representing the United States of America, Nathan Chen.
So the stage has been set. The final skater of the night, and with the world title his for the taking, 18-year-old Nathan Chen from Salt Lake City, the two-time U.S. champion. And we all remember the disappointment in PyeongChang, followed by the redemptive free skate. He needs another moment like that today.
And Tanith, you talked about that moment in the free skate. He won that portion of the event, but still, he didn't get what he wanted out of the Olympics. He wants a win here. It's time for a gold medal. We have 5 or 6 quads coming up. Beautiful quad lutz to open.
Quad flip, double toe.
Third quad down, beautiful quad flip. He said he was going to go for 5 quads because it is so risky, especially in the second half, to add that 6th quad. But he looks very on today. It'll be interesting to see if he throws another one in.
He's the only man that has shown up for this competition. He's the only one that looks through the eyes, even, present for this competition. He's here for a medal, whereas everybody else was fighting to defend a position. Could be quads number 4, 5, and 6.
Quad toe, triple toe, 5 quads down. Everyone, you are looking at the new world champion. Nathan, just give us another quad. Just for fun.
Little mistake, but quad number 6.
Nathan Chen, completely undeniable. No question, this is a gold medal performance.
Clearly the world champion, the quad king, lives up to his name once again. That was incredible to watch. It was almost perfect.
King Nathan.
After what we saw at the Olympic Games, it would be reasonable to think when Nathan takes to the ice, you might hold your breath, wonder, is this going to be another disappointing... When Nathan takes to the ice, you might hold your breath, wonder, is this going to be another disappointing skate? But yet, when he takes the ice, I'm still caught by his command. He has so much confidence.
At the Olympics, it was such a shock that he even made any mistakes, because he always has this confident swagger. He is head and shoulders above the rest of the competition in what he plans technically, so it gives him such a cushion that he can have that swagger. And at the Olympics, it was just so disappointing. The short programs that he skated that were so tough, that redeeming free skate, but this is the Nathan Chen that we're used to seeing.
This is redemption, and not just a great way to end your season with a world gold medal, but for him personally, this must mean a lot.
The way you finish a season, so important for any athlete, that this be the lasting impression looking towards the next 4 years. Oh boy. Even his coach, Rafael Artunian, pretty happy with those numbers.
Even Nathan's presentation score, a huge improvement over what we saw even a year ago. It was just an impressive, kingly free skate.
And with that overall score, just over 320 points, Nathan Chen would have won the Olympic Games had those numbers come up in Pyeongchang. Look at that point differential to second place. And with Max Aaron's finish, the United States does qualify three spots to next year's World Championships. And now it's time for the Prudential Challenging Move. And no question about it, it is Nathan Chen, and it's the quad lutz. Absolutely beautiful way to start this program, worth nearly 16 points, the highest scoring of his six quads, if that wasn't impressive enough. And that was the Prudential Challenging Move. So after the competition, we caught up with the new world champion, who knew that that title was his for the taking.
I saw the scores and I was like, okay, something's up. Like, there's got to be, like, must have made a lot of mistakes. But that definitely, you know, opened up my, you know, possibilities of landing six quads and, you know, at least just, like, allowing myself to try that. I mean, I'm glad the season actually went the way that it did. Starting from the, you know, very beginning of the season, you know, I started working my way up to the games. And obviously the games didn't go as well as I'd wanted it to. But again, I learned so much from it, and the games, you know, with the way that I did, it was super valuable as a learning experience, and definitely helped me here and I think into the future as well.
And with that, Nathan Chen is the new world champion. On a night when others faltered, he rose to the occasion. So the final event of the season has come to an end, but a reminder, you can watch your favorite events with video on demand at icenetwork.com. For Tara Lipinski and Johnny Weir, I'm Tanith White. So long for now, and thanks for joining us.